and welcome to Chromebook training. The first thing I want to make sure is that you have your Chromebook with you so we can go through this training together. One way to identify a Chromebook just at a quick glance is looking for this symbol right here in the corner. It's the Chrome symbol with the word Chrome next to it. If you do not see this, it's likely you have one of the Dell laptops that looks a lot like a Chromebook. But it's not a Chromebook. A laptop and a Chromebook are two very different things. So make sure you have your Chromebook with you. And the first thing I'm going to do is start by looking at the side of the Chromebook. Here is the port where you plug in the headphones. This is a soft button that's the power switch. And another button here that is volume control. I'm going to look at the other side now. This is the port for the charger, an SD card reader, HDMI port, and two USB ports. I'm going to open up the Chromebook. It looks a lot like a laptop, and the first thing you're probably noticing is the keyboard looks a little different. There are no function keys. There's no caps lock key. We're going to talk to you more about the keyboard. There's a separate video that we will link you to that explains everything you need to know about the keyboard. One other thing about this particular model of keyboard is that it will flip to a tent like this, or if you collapse it all the way, it's a tablet. And in tablet mode, the keyboard is not functional. I'm going to flip it back to laptop mode. Turn it around this way, and I'm going to have you look on your keyboard, on your Chromebook. If it's asking you or giving you a message about it being managed, you're going to have to press the blue next button. You'll notice that I touched the screen. This model is a touchscreen Chromebook. You can also use the touchpad and tap on it. When you get this screen, you're going to have two options. First option is this circle right here. That is to sign in with the QR code. If you tap on this green button up here, that is signing in with your PISD credentials. So I'm going to tap that. It's going to come to this particular screen. In the top field, it says first name dot last name. That is going to be your PISD network login. So for teachers, it's first name dot last name. For students, their network login is their first name dot last name dot and then a number. So if you have a student that has the same name as another student in PISD, it's likely they'll have a dot two or dot three. If they're the only one with that name, they're going to be a dot one. The password will be your PISD network password. The students just changed those at the start of this school year. So whatever password you use to log into your desktop computer is the password that you'll use to log in here. So we will stop this training now, and please watch part two to see what happens after you sign in on a PISD managed Chromebook.